Everyday Agenda Podcast is a presentation of Spreaker Studios and Angel Song Productions. Oh my God, goodness, welcome to my Everyday Agenda Podcast from Spreaker Studios and Angel Song Productions. We're here at Do Space Podcast Studios at 90th and 4th Street in Omaha, Nebraska. It's me, LHMusic. And great show for you today as well for the next 60 or should I say 55 minutes, whatever it is. So you just had to trust me about that as far as we're concerned. Anyways, you might think you're so smart about last Wednesday and Thursday's choir rehearsal, called as a hymn festival choir rehearsal time at Resurrection at 30th and Belvedere, and so is St. Andrew's Episcopal Church at 84th and Pacific Street. And we practice these three songs for the hymn festival last Wednesday, and then we meet Tom Trenney, and so is Michael Bauer, as far as we're concerned. And I saw Keith Whitten at Zozo Coffee House last Saturday while I was coming back in and eating my, taking a rest and all that stuff, so who knows talk about. So I'll explain this about this hymn festival choir rehearsal thing, you know what I'm talking about. And don't forget, getting to know Tom and Michael is up for grabs as well. Artist reception time at Artist Cooperative Gallery. And, you know, this artwork, it really makes a lot of sense, called Phenomenology. And it could be, the study of the phenomena of the things experience. I have no clue whatsoever, so who knows, could be civilized about, yeah, this is a unique artist reception for this October exhibition. Well, I guess whatever it is, plus Rachel's world, Rachel's thoughts, and so it's a recap of, you guessed it, last month's, you guessed it, September 2024. And so it's my opening thoughts. And, oh God, Tina has done it again. Why? Because you always, everybody has, you don't have wings. And you don't have a halo. Oh, you just wearing a, that's why you're wearing a backpack. And I told Dale that you're going to get what you deserve. Well, I'll explain this for my closing thoughts. Oh, boy. And I'll give the information of this Everyday Agenda Podcast, so help us God. So who knows, get me civilized about this. Anyways, it's up for grabs. So tune in whatever you can for my Everyday Agenda. And this is what happens. Can be civilized. Okay, here's my opening thought for you that you don't want to know about this, as far as we're concerned. Now, doesn't anybody else know about Hurricane Helene? Last couple weeks about Hurricane Helene is, I think it's, and this is why I type up, you guessed it, Helene, yes, this is what happens, because everything else can be civilized about Hurricane Helene, because all the conspiracy theories and all that could be a tropical storm in North Carolina, could be a widespread things that you ought to know. So this is what happens. Hurricane Helene has caused a widespread destruction of, you know who, that's right, of the United States, southeastern United States, impacting Florida, Georgia, South Carolina, North Carolina, Virginia, and Tennessee. So, this is why the storm surges for this wind damage and all that. Well, you just have to trust me about this forest we concern. Could be a wind damage and inland flooding. And this is why has been catastrophic, with neighborhoods flooded, with residents stranding and homes destroying it. Oh, wow. This is what happens. You don't want to try this at home. And all the news about Hurricane Helene and all that. So this is what happens about Category 4. So what comes next in the list of things? Yeah. Tropical Storm Milton. Oh, yeah. Now, here's my observation according to NBC News. Uh-oh. This is why it happens. Don't try this at home. At least 223 people are dead. People are died, and hundreds could be accounted for this destruction and landfall in Florida. And more than a week later, communities has been restored, isolated, and hundreds of thousands are without power. Oh my God. This is going to be worse than it could happen. So here's my observation for you. Because this is, it don't even make sense at all about people as digging out of their muck and survey the damages to their homes. And there are stories about heroic rescues are devastating losses at a time like this. This is why it happens. So, I don't mind, because National Voluntary Organizing Active Disaster in disaster and all that. So, could be civilized. So, this is why everything else about Hurricane Helene. And I meant to tell you this. Things are going to get worse and all that, as far as we're concerned, because over this week, it happens. And could be catastrophic by the numbers and all that. And that could be worse. This is, and you think is so smart about this one, because it could be a tropical cyclone, could be a widespread destruction. And I don't know why it happens back in 2017, since Hurricane Maria has landed. Could be the fifth hurricane and the second time around, you know. Well, it became, yeah. Well, it happens. So that means, according to, yes, last month, National Hurricane Center has been highlighted. Tropical, yes, you know, all kinds of stuff. And what the preparations in Mexico, Caribbean, and so is Cuba and the rest of the United States. And it happens. Happens all the time. Could be the aftermath of this. And, back in 2024, Omaha Public Power District helped these mutual aid crews to West Virginia, thanks to OPPD, and, wasted electricity, all that, so, could be very important. And what about the NFL? Yeah, Atlanta Falcons, Carolina Panthers, Houston Texans, and Tampa Bay Buccaneers. has donated $8 million for the relief fund, according to NFL Foundation, and all the sports teams have been contributed to that as well. And well, political, I know I'm not going to get inside the political stuff because I don't want to hear it, because this is the worst that could happen. So everything else civilized. Oh God. So that's you know who. So if you want to take a look at the advisory archives of Hurricane Helene, it's best for you to go to nhc.noaa.gov, and you know all kinds of hurricane reliefs and all that stuff. So you better try it for now. Or if you or if you want to find shelter and all kinds of stuff, go to the American Red Cross, or and needs more help and others. So all the disaster medical relief, finding shelter and all that stuff. So still, don't worry, I'll put web links and all that stuff, so it can help. And I meant to tell you this, it's all good. You know what I'm talking about. Trust me. Okay. And finally, yeah, we're almost there, because next Tuesday and next Friday could be, yeah, that's right, last rehearsal for OSC and dress rehearsal. So before next Sunday's, you guessed it, performance at Countryside Community Church. You know, it starts at 2 o'clock, so that means I got to get going with this. That's right. The songs that we got to perform, and I'll explain that next week. So, on my Everyday Agenda podcast, so be sure you tune in to that. And change of plans. You guessed it. That's right. Thursday, Saturday Night Blaze Nation is moving to a, you guessed it. Let me check my calendar. October 19th. So, this could be wonderful. But before we inside our fifth anniversary season premiere, I think we a couple quick things. It's got to be Friday Night Blaze Nation podcast from Podbean. So, just remember that I move over to Spreaker Studios, so this is what happens. Friday Night Blaze Nation is a podcast from Podbean, and I'm going to get it right. You know what I'm talking about. With a little bit of politics all the way up to pop culture, and you guessed it. And I got to do my website as well, probably next weekend or so. So after I deal with washing my clothes, or before I got dress rehearsal for OSC at Countryside, Community Church, Faith Plaza in Omaha. So that'll be good. That'll be awesome. So it's gonna be wonderful. So mark your calendars on October 18th for this podcast. Yes, Friday Night Blaze Nation podcast from Podbean. It could be a series premiere. It's going to be wonderful. And don't miss the website, 5th anniversary season premiere of Saturday Night Blaze Nation. Not Thursday night, but Saturday Night Blaze Nation. It's going to be wonderful. So I'll update the website from Weebly.com and take it from there. So who knows? Okay, enough of this thing. All right, let's get started. You know who. This one, so who knows. Anyways, you're listening to my Everyday Agenda podcast from Angel Song Productions and Spreaker Studios, and oh boy, what comes next on the list of things? Here it is. You might think it's so smart about, you guessed it, Hymn Festival Choir Rehearsal at Resurrection at St. Andrew's, but here it is.
Weak and wounded sinner, lost and left to die. Raise your head, for love is passing by. Come to Jesus, come to Jesus, come to Jesus.
Now, you might think it's so smart about last Wednesday's Wednesday night choir rehearsal time at Resurrection. So, this is what happens if you notice that we practice these three songs that are arranged by Tom Trenney. And don't rattle against that, Tom Trenney's mind, as far as we're concerned, trust me. I know what I'm saying. So, as I said last Sunday, Michael Bauer practiced with me and Jeannie, and so is my Resurrection Singers, doing three songs of this one. Three songs that everybody knows about. And I got a folder. Let me check this out for yourself. And oh, boy. All right. Here it is. Here it is. So, anyways. So, this is why we practice these three songs. How Firm a Foundation. And, that's why Sopranos, oh boy, has it first and all that stuff. And so is It Is Well With My Soul. And by the way, why is everything else singing high tenor and high soprano descants? Well, it belongs to soprano. And so this is why I sang the melody line and all that. So, you just have to trust me about this one, because everything else can be civilized or whatever. So, who knows? And, this is finally, yes, Will You Come and Follow Me? And this is why Michael Bauer wants it that way, about this one. So, that means last Wednesday, we practiced, Lead Me, Guide Me, for the Bishop Barker coming to Resurrection this Sunday. And this is how it happens, so who knows. So after this one, so we're headed to St. Andrews, so who knows. That's where we practice these three songs, How Firm a Foundation, and so is, you guessed it, It Is Well With My Soul, and Will You Come and Follow Me, backwards. So, it happens. So, this is how it happens. It's going to be ending of it. You know what I'm talking about. But LHMusic, what about Nola? Yeah, she's here last Wednesday. But last Sunday, she wasn't feeling too well. So, I take over the reins, directing your guests to get all excited with my Resurrection Singers. And people are having so much fun and listen and all that stuff. So, trust me. So, I know. It could be civilized. So, anyways, because last Wednesday we at Resurrection. And last Thursday, I was waiting to pick me up at VA, and Nola shows up, and wow, it's about time to get ready to pick me up, and who knows. And we went to Panera Bread at 78th and Dodge Street, and I take a look at this, and Nola says it was, yeah, Jeannie and Michelle and my Resurrection Singers inside. And that's why I got inside and I'm ready to join my and Nola tell me that I'm supposed to be ordering because she already ate lunch, so that's all. So I got myself a ciabatta cheesesteak and chips and my raspberry tea and this is an electronic device to call my name to get the order of this food and I join with that joining with yes, that's right. Nola, and so is Michelle, and Dodie, and the rest of my Resurrection Singers, and oh gosh, we ate and talked and all that stuff, and I cannot believe my eyes and ears about that as well. As far as we, so that means after we ate a little bit of light lunch at Panera Bread. Yeah, I know. Banana bread, and we go to you guessed it, St. Andrew's Episcopal Church at 84th and Pacific Street, and I bet the door is open, and you guessed it, Michael Bauer and Tom Trenney, Tom Trenney, is here to practice, and this is gonna be outrageous. And you know, I saw Keith Whitten. You know, Keith sang with me and at my church at Resurrection years ago. Now he's the rector for St. Andrew's Episcopal Church, and I'm deeply surprised about that, and we just know that. Just met, and we always know that we practice. So that means Tom Trenney, yes. I got a choir packet inside my folder. So that means we rehearsed the hymns, it doesn't matter if you have music and all that stuff, so who knows, could be civilized about that as well. Could be and so is the reflection, all that. So that means we practice how firm a foundation and all that, and it is well with my soul. Now, Tom has a very sense of humor, and I kind of like that. So that means, by the way, we just met at Trinity Episcopal Church over the years for this Abend music. And this is going to be good. No questions asked. So that means we did practice It Is Well My Soul. And what about... will you come and follow me and all that stuff? So this should be fun. So it's gonna be a wonderful service and all that stuff, and it could be a hymn festival inviting to answer the call and to do justice all that. So Tom Trenney is our guest conductor, and I have no attention whatsoever, so you be surprised about that as well. And that's why could be civilized about this one. And this is gonna be good. I'm speechless, but who knows? You're listening to my Everyday Agenda podcast from Angel Song Productions and Spreaker Studios. Okay, do you know what time it is? It's time to what? All right, it's time for another edition of Getting to Know You. And these two guys that you all know by now, Michael Bauer and Tom Trenney. So, I always start with Michael Bauer. Because I know Michael, couple of years ago about, ordination at, ordination and, and this, I'll tell you one thing is, this guy has a wonderful sense of humor, and I have no attention whatsoever. So that's why he is the guy who plays the organ and so is directing the choir for You guessed it. That's right. Mm-hmm. St. Andrews. And Michael Bauer traditional worship music for all his responsibilities. He's a professor of organ and church music at the University of Kansas. And, oh boy, this is going to be good. And he's also a published author, a recitalist, and now you know it happens. And I am very proud to say that about the staff and all that, as far as we're concerned. And that's why Michael was married by Marie Ruiz Bauer. Which you probably know about, because I know Marie and at St. Cecilia's as a organist and choir director, and this is why I sang at St. Cecilia's, Cathedral Church, Archdiocese and Chorale events, and so is Christmas at the Cathedral with OSC, and I meant to say this, but this is going to be good. So who knows? So this is why I'm getting to know Michael Bauer so much about that as well. So could be a interesting thought as well. Anyways, and the next one that you ought to know by now is Tom Trenney. Now, Just remember that Tom Trenney does all that songs, all kinds of songs, and the arrangements for these three songs, and I have no clue whatsoever. And that's why Tom Trenney is a this guy, yes, he's a sacred music composer, and I mean he is serving as minister of music at First Plymouth Church in Lincoln, Nebraska. You can see, Reach Out and Live, the telecast on television, and because this is what happens in 2009, that's why he got started. And in 2019, he was invited to become a associate professor of music and director of choirs and all that. That's why he performing in all the churches, colleges, and concert halls across America. And that's why he graduated from the Cleveland Institute of Music at Eastman School of Music. This is why he was so grateful. And this guy has a sense of humor and all that. So, could be to all his teachers and mentors and all. And you just had to trust me about this, as far as we're concerned. And this is how it happens. How it happens that, you know, could be life challenging. And why? And life could be worse. And this is why. And he composed all the music. Music like Light of Unity and... for the music of creation and I hope that we just rehearse. Will you come and follow me? How firm a foundation, and so is Rise and Shine, that with Marcus Garrett, last couple years, sang with OSC last couple years, and I've no attention as whatsoever. So this is how it sounds, and it's going to be perfect about that as well. And all the vocal soloists and all that. So this is what happens. It happens again. Well, guess what? You might be surprised at getting to know Michael Bauer and all that. So trust me. You know what I'm saying. Same. And what about Tom Trenney? Yeah, this guy's good. So, these guys have, and you know everything else can be soloist. So that's why getting to know Michael Bauer and Tom Trenney does all the music and choral works and all that stuff. So, you'd be surprised about that. So, who knows? You're listening to my Everyday Agenda podcast from Spreaker Studios and Angel Song Productions. Okay, you know what time it is. It's a you-know-who artist cooperative gallery thing for this artist reception that I went to inside the old market in Omaha, Nebraska. And I, you know... Artist Cooperative Gallery does all the artist receptions and all that stuff, so trust me. But the one I think about this and really makes sense at all times is phenomenology. So what does phenomenology really mean? Well, these two artists does things together, as far as we're concerned. And could be immense exhibit. Could be a unique show exploring the intersections of surreal and, you guessed it, nature, and all the experience through distinct yet a complementary mediums. So that is why it happens. So this is gonna be huge, trust me. Because this is what happens. Her name is Nash Bellows. And that's why she is a captive surreal artist. Does surreal collages, blending blending landscapes and dreamlike environments that are transporting the viewers to otherworldly realms. So... this is why I saw this, and oh boy, you don't want to know about this. Is all the painting, all the digital painting, and all that. So, and all kinds of stuff. Now, what about Gabriel Quiroz? Yes, She's a master of color pencils, yeah, drawings and all that stuff. And bringing, yes, that's right, details of drawings of floral and fauna and bringing to life vibrant hues. That means an offering of contemplative look at the nature's inner world of you know, art. And I cannot believe my eyes and ears. This is what this, and you know, I saw this, and I have no clue whatsoever. And it could be rainbow days, and I saw this one, and I said something about, yeah, rabbit in the hole, and I have no clue whatsoever about this one, and I couldn't find her, so. And I have no agenda. It could be exhibits and all that. And I have, this is gonna be, you know, this is why I walk around and all that stuff. So, well, you know, it pays to be nice to people, or anyone could be civilized about this one. Or maybe it's sounds like the artist that you know about it. So this is why I saw the painting. This is why I see all those paintings and other things. Goes everybody's mind. So trust me about it, as far as we're concerned. So it could be October, you know. And this is what happens. Now, in November, exhibition. Could be, you know, since back in 1975, all the members of the conducting educational cultural outreach activities of the staff and all that stuff. So that could be, these openings are provided to the public, to the opportunity and all that. And that is why it happens all the time, and this is what is going on about the art world. And it doesn't matter, everything else can be civilized about the artwork and all the artist receptions. And, you know, could be huge. So, this is what happens. Let's see. Oh, yes. And it goes on and on. Yes. And until it's over with, and what comes next? November exhibition, you know, yeah, class act for themselves. So kudos to Nash and Gabriel, could be artists at the Artist Creative Gallery. You'll love it, trust me. You're listening to my Everyday Agenda podcast from Angel Song Productions and Podbean. Okay, so here's Rachel talk about this drinking water. I know, 95 degrees. Could be a heat stroke and all that. So take a look and listen to this from Rachel and her thoughts.
It is Wellness Wednesday, so I wanted to come on and share a little bit. Drink your water, first of all. Always, always, always drink your water. Stay hydrated. You should be drinking half your body weight in ounces of water a day. So if you're 100, you should be drinking 50. If you're 200, you should be drinking 100. It's half of whatever you weigh. I always am telling my family, stay hydrated, stay hydrated, stay hydrated. And so water is so important. But I also wanted to come on and talk about, I have been hitting 10,000 steps every single day for the good majority. I think I had 3 days that I did not hit it due to issue. Like one day, my body just, I had to stop. It said rest. And the other two were Monday and Tuesday of this week because it was a little chaotic and my family needed me. But let's talk about what 10,000 steps a day can do for you. So, walking 10,000 steps a day burns between 2 to 3,500 calories a week, which can equal out to losing a pound a week, depending on your weight and your intake of food and how hard you exercise. But 1 pound of body fat equals 3,500 calories. So if you do 10,000 steps and you burn 3,500 calories a week, you could lose up to 1 pound a week or more. It all depends. Guys, walking is where it all started for me. When I was 400 pounds, that's all I could do. That's honestly what I couldn't do. I could barely walk, but that's what started, getting more steps and getting more movement. So here's a few other things about 10,000 steps a day and what it can do for you. It improves bone health. It can also prevent osteoporosis. I can tell you that I have knee injuries, and honestly, I was really concerned about the amount of steps. My knee, it may ache, but it feels so much better when I do my steps. It hurts when I sit down and don't do anything, honestly. It also reduces the risk of heart disease. As you guys know, I had gotten COVID 2 times last year, and it attacked my heart. And when I went to the cardiologist January through April, when I was in almost heart failure because of the COVID, they could not hoop and holler about my gut health products and what it was doing, because what I was doing was strengthening my immune system, strengthening my body, helping my cardiovascular, and they were just, keep doing it, what they said. Okay, so let's continue. There's even more, you guys. There's so much for what 10,000 steps does for you. It affects your mood. It improves your mood and your confidence. It also helps increase your self-esteem. Guys, that has been me. Like, doing these 10,000 steps really pushes me some days, and I have to work for it. Other days, I don't have to, but it feels good. It proves to yourself that you are capable of doing so much more. It also helps you sleep better, reduces stress. That is my stress reliever. Jogging, that run, that high, it just makes my day. That is a lot of times what I use for stress. It improves your cardiovascular fitness. Absolutely sure does, because the more activity I was, the better my heart got stronger and stronger. And then I wasn't in heart failure, and my cardiologist is like, see you later, we'll see you in a year. Okay, and then the last video of the last few things. It reduces dementia, reduces the risk of dementia. It also reduces the risk of cancer. And walking is a low impact. So the good majority of us, unless we have feet injuries or something that causes us to have a hard time walking, we still have to walk around. And so just getting a few more steps in a day can make such a huge drastic difference in your life. But I'm constantly posting. I'm doing 10,000 steps a day. My 10,000 step challenge is over now, but I'm going to continue it every single day. That is going to be my goal, to get that 10,000 steps in. And I'll tell you what, it is the best exercise I ever have done for myself. It has so many, just that one thing, just getting 10,000 steps in a day can do all of those things. So what are you going to do? How many steps?
Wow, that could be interesting. Could be, it, you know, drinking water. It really makes sense about this one. Thank you, Rachel. All right. That means you're listening to my Everyday Agenda podcast from Angel Song Productions and Spreaker Studios. Okay, now you know what time it is. Let's recap on this one. All right, recapping, yes, last month's, you guessed it, September. As we get started, yes, season premiere with a Labor Day picnic at the Elkies in Fort Calhoun, Nebraska. I meant to tell you this, it's going to be good. You know, all the bear caves and all that stuff for kids. And we have a wonderful time at the Elkies, and so is Reverend Tony and Amy and the rest of my resurrection congregational thing, you know what I'm talking about. So, who knows? And what about, you guessed it, Omaha Creative Arts Open House at the VA Hospital? Yeah, inside ACC hallway. And it has all kinds of artists. You can paint and all kinds of stuff. Plus goodies. Oh, boy. It's going to be wonderful. Wednesday night Rehearsal Time season premiere at Resurrection. Oh, Lord have mercy. It's going to be awesome. Rehearsing all kinds of stuff with Jeannie and Nola and the rest of my Resurrection singers. And it's going to be perfect. What about the block party celebration at Resurrection? And so is Deacon Betsy's retirement at Resurrection 2, as far as we're concerned. Because the block party has, yeah, little bit of members and face painting, hot dogs, and all kinds of stuff. So, without the music. Yeah, we'll find out the music is next year, whatever it is. And Deacon Betsy, retirement. Yeah, that'll be good. And saying goodbye to Deacon Betsy. You have a little bit of cake, and without the ice cream, it melted. Well, whatever. Could be civilized. Oh, yes. Benedictine Way's 6th anniversary thing for this foundation, for this Incarnate Monastery. And, in Omaha. It's a blast. I cannot believe my eyes and ears. We have all kinds of this one with a single voice and a single breath. We did the all that stuff. Father Barker does it. You know what I'm talking about. And what about getting to know, you know, about this one's going to be civilized. And Coots Memorial Lutheran Church has a annual church picnic at Coots Memorial. It was a blast. I cannot believe my eyes and ears. Could be life challenging, so trust me. What about getting to know you segment and all kinds of stuff like Rick Warren and all that stuff, so trust me about this one. And Father Bishop Barker inside New Horizons newspaper and all kinds of and so is Pastor Judy from Coots Memorial and all that, and it'll be perfect. So what about Rachel's thoughts and all that stuff? That's gonna be something to remember in September for this one. So what comes next? Yeah, I know this month I have and it's gonna be perfect, trust me. That could be awesome as far as we're concerned, whatever it is. So, saying goodbye to September, say hello to this month. Yeah, October. And it's almost there for OSC performance next Sunday and all that stuff. So, this is going to be huge. Believe it or not, I know. It can happen. Trust me. And, you know what I'm saying. Trust me. You're listening to my Everyday Agenda podcast from Angel Sound Productions and Podbean. No, not Podbean. Oh, yeah, that's right. Yes. Spreaker Studios. Okay. I will leave you with this closing thought. If all of you don't mind, here's why. Just remember that I just said to Tina last week. And now because, oh boy, that's why Dale and myself have words of wisdom with Tina, because she doesn't have wings. She doesn't have angel, doesn't have a halo. You might think it's so sweat. Oh, I'm crushed. Yeah. You can say all you want, Tina. You don't have a halo. And you don't have wings. For once. That's why Dale and I have been discussing discussing this for a reason, for you to pray to God and go to church and you ask for forgiveness. And you told Dale to get out of here. Get out. How rude. This is why it happens. I have no clue whatsoever. Tina, be nice to Dale. And be nice to me. And don't be bad as well. Trust me. If you be nice again, you wish. Talk to the hand. And I'm never going to trust you until you apologize and be good for now. That's all I can say. Trust me. So, for once, I'll be watching you, Tina, start next week. Before it really, really, really does, it could happen from now on. Trust me. Okay, that's it. I have nothing else to say, so wrap this up, shall we? Okay, so what we learned about Hymn Festival Choir Rehearsal last Wednesday and last Thursday at Resurrection at 30th and Belvedere and St. Andrew's Episcopal Church at 84th and Pacific Street. And I'll tell you what, it's a huge blast for all the rehearsals and all that stuff. So that means thanks to, yes, myself, Jeannie, and so is Nola for practicing with my Resurrection Singers for these three songs. And so is Michael Bauer and Tom Trenney for doing this. You know, it's going to be a wonderful, awesome hymn festival that you don't want to miss. This Sunday, after we deal with this, you guessed it, Bishop Barker has a lots more going on with this annual bishop thing, and so is Podluck. I bet fried chicken does it. This is why I saw this on Facebook. Well, I hope so. All right, Artist Cooperative Gallery, you guessed it, artist reception about this phenomena thing, artist. Nash, let's see, Nash, Nash Gallows, Nash Gallows does a wonderful work and all that stuff, and I have no clue whatsoever. It's going to be perfect. Well, at least we all learn about that as well, but about this one, so you just have to trust me about that as far as we're concerned. Anyways, Rachel's thoughts about drinking water and 10,000 steps and a need to exercise, including diabetical things and all that stuff. So, you know what I'm saying. If anyone else can be civilized about this one, trust me. Recap of You Know Who, that's right. September 2024. About this Labor Day picnic at the Elkies, all the way up to You Know Who. That's right. Kutz Memorial's annual church picnic, and I have no clue whatsoever, so I'll be surprising about that as well. So who knows? Could be civilized about that. Trust me. And then getting to know you segments from Rick Warren last September. But I know that Michael Bauer and Tom Trenney are getting to know everything else for this segment of getting to know you about that. And it's going to be perfect. And Hurricane Helene, God forbid, pray for the communities, from Florida all the way up to North Carolina and all the parts of this southwestern United States thing for this catastrophe and all the supplies and all the sheltering and all that stuff. So, trust me. And I hope you learn your lesson, Tina, because you don't have... Yes, that's right! Mm-hmm, that's right. Halo. You don't have a halo, and you don't have wings. All you got is a backpack. If you don't, Dale and I will destroy you. Like, yeah, like ants. You know what it's all about. Oh, boy. That's it for now. So what comes next on the list of things? I got doctor's appointment, and so is hymn festival and dress rehearsals for OSC and all that stuff in October. So that could be good. Check the website, LHMusic6.wixsite.com/everydayagenda. And you can download the podcast from iHeartRadio all the way up to YouTube Music. And pays to be nice to people or whatever happens. And follow me on my social media websites and all that stuff. So it's going to be cool. Anyways, we got to get out of here. And hope we're almost out of time. So we'll do this again next weekend. You know what I'm talking about. For my everyday agenda at Deuce Space Podcast Studios. And I'm signing off from LH Music. Take care. See you next week. Everyday Agenda Podcast is a presentation of Angel Song Productions and Spreaker Studios.